I'm Valerie. I'm a pet care advisor, and I'm here with my friend Tootsie. He's a parakeet. And today we're going to be talking about a problem that can happen in your bird seed. One of the great things about pet birds is they don't eat a lot of seed. But for that reason, if you purchase your bird seed in a large quantity, maybe trying to stock up and save, you can run into a problem with something called Indian meal moths or grain moths. These are microscopic eggs that are present on all types of seed, and specifically seeds that are used for non-human consumption will not be treated to remove those eggs. The moths are little, about half inch long, kind of grayish color moths. Their larvae are little, again, about a half inch long, off-white colored. They look like maggots. Basically, I know this all sounds gross, but it's a very realistic problem that bird owners and anybody who stores any type of seed, whether it's wild bird seed, pet bird seed, small animal mixes, you should be aware of this problem. So what happens is the adult moth will lay eggs on the seeds, whether they're growing in the field, if they're in storage facilities someplace, they actually can get in there, they can get into small places and lay the eggs. The eggs lay dormant for quite a long time. It can take as little as 27 days, but sometimes up to 300 days, depending on heat, humidity, other different conditions. So these eggs are present on all these seeds. So seed is not cooked in any way. What happens, it goes into the packaging, and then depending on how long it sits on the shelf at the store or in the warehouse before it gets to the store, and then what you do with it when you get it to your home, all can make a difference on whether or not these eggs are going to hatch. One thing you can tell is if you see any kind of webs when you're looking in through the bag, if you see any kind of little cottony webs in there, that would be an indication that there's worms in there, that the eggs have hatched into worms. The worms or the eggs are non-toxic to the birds. They're not harmful at all. And one thing that you can do to just completely prevent this problem from occurring inside your house, when you get your bird seed, if you get a small bag like this, you can just put the entire bag like this, or put it into freezer bags and freeze it for a minimum of 7 days. That freezing will kill the eggs. You can also just keep it stored in the refrigerator. You just don't want it to get too warm in a normal house temperature. Over time, you're going to probably have the problem of hatching. So what the manufacturers try to do, these two packages you can see are the kind of crunchier plastic, very slippery, not very flexible. This is a vapor lock bag, so when they're putting the seed into the bag at the factory, what they do is they flush nitrogen in as the seed goes in and quickly seal the bag up. So basically that pushes all the oxygen out of the bag. So this bag, unopened, is going to be fine. There's no oxygen in there. Without oxygen, the eggs can't hatch. This type of bag might actually, this is probably not nitrogen flushed because it's not that slippery plastic. If you buy your bird seed in the large bulk 20-pound paper bags, those are not nitrogen flushed either, so they're going to be more likely to have a problem with hatching at some point. Again, freezing the product immediately, storing it in a refrigerator is definitely something that you want to do as soon as you get the product into your home. When you freeze the product, I mean, if you're just going to, you only want to keep out what you're going to feed in about a 2-week period. You can use airtight storage containers such as these. Even though they're airtight, does not mean they're oxygen proof. So the eggs could still hatch inside this container. So you probably want to keep everything in the refrigerator or freezer, put what you're going to use in a 2-week period into one of these containers, and then when you run out of the seed in the container, make sure that you empty and wash the container. There could be eggs that fell off and are in the bottom of the container. Keep that very clean. Keep the floor of your bird's cage and any areas in the room where the bird is free of any seed. The little crevices in between the tray on the bottom here, you could certainly get seeds in there. Make sure that that's all cleaned out regularly so that you're not having a breeding ground for the moth larva inside the cage. If you do see larvae or moths flying around, they can actually get into your pantry. They're not the same as the fabric-eating moths, but they do eat grains, things like that, so they can get into your flour, your pretzels, your pasta. So you probably do want to talk to an exterminator if you do have, if it has gotten to that level in your home. One other note, foods like dog food and cat food, dry dog food and cat food, are cooked at high temperatures, so the eggs are killed in that cooking process. It's normally not an occurrence in products that are baked or cooked, but these raw seeds definitely could have viable seeds on them. I hope you found this helpful. I know it's a nasty, you know, subject, but it is important for you to know. Thank you.